Henshaws products.
Welcome to Henshaws tips, tricks and definitely tech. Today I'm going to talk to you about the OrCam 2.0 with my friend Ian.
Hi, I'm Ian White from OrCam and I'm here today to give you all my hints and tips about how to use OrCam because I'm severely sight impaired and I use it on a day-to-day basis.
So then, features. OrCam's packed full of features and it's our job to tell you what they are. So feature one, reading. Obviously, it's a reading device, but it seriously does a lot more than just reading. So Ian, how does it read?
Yeah, there's various activation methods, Mark. Our focused one is the pointing gesture, where we take our index finger, pointing it to the ceiling with the nail bed facing your nose. And when you point into an area of text, you hear a little click, you drop your finger out the camera's view, and the camera will instantaneously read that text where you're pointing into the area of.
The closest thing I come to creating something in the kitchen.
So that little click that Ian introduced is basically it's taking a photograph of the text that you present into it. So that's one of the ways it does it. What are the others?
The second way is you can tap the touchpad on the side of the OrCam and it will take an image of the text and it will read all the text that it sees.
Sponge cakes or 13 cupcakes, which wouldn't be good.
Then there's kind of a search mode, isn't there, where you move your finger along?
There's what we call touch reading,
okay,
where we can navigate to find out certain features what we want to read. So for example, if you're in a restaurant and you're using a menu, you can place your finger on the item and OrCam will focus three lines of text above the tip of your finger. As it starts to read to you, so it's running live, you move your finger slowly down the middle of the item, the menu, and it will slowly read off the features as it goes. When you pause your finger, keeping it in place, the OrCam will pause at the tip of your finger and then as you move your finger down it will resume reading. So we can move a finger around the menu and get different features, starters, main courses, cheese boards.
And it reads at distance as well. We're not just talking about text in your hand. It can read things that are not in your kind of location. So street signs, bus stops, billboards. If you can see the text, it'll read it.
Manchester United, Old Trafford Town Hall.
It's got another fantastic mode that I call stare mode. So Ian, tell us about that.
Page auto recognition feature. I love this. This is one of my favourite features in OrCam. You open up your book, you don't make a gesture at all, you just stare at the two pages for 2 to 3 seconds, and if OrCam doesn't see or feel a tap gesture, it will automatically read the two pages of text that sees in front of it.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, it's fantastic when you're on a flight, you know, you're just relaxing, you get your book out, just hold it up in front of you and you get some really strange looks. People have seen you coming on the plane.
Yeah, how's he reading?
Yeah, it's one of the best features. Yeah, I love it.
Let's talk about facial recognition. So facial recognition does what it says on the tin, really. It allows you to program a face and it will recognise that at a later event, merely by just coming into the camera focus. It's a fantastic feature.
I'm with a lady called Patricia. Patricia is completely blind. During the training, we done the facial recognition. That was her main purpose for purchasing the OrCam, was the facial recognition. Patricia's daughter, Catherine, was sitting in the training with us. So we go through the facial recognition features. When we took an image of the daughter and there was a pitch tone, please name the person in front of you. I pointed to the daughter and she said, it's Catherine. And then Patricia turns to her daughter and says, go out the room, out the room. So Catherine leaves the room and Patricia sits down in the settee and she says, right, come in now. And Catherine came in right away. It said Catherine in her voice.
Yeah.
okay? Now, if you've ever seen these Jerry Springer shows where the mum and the daughter stand up and scream and wave their hands in the floor and hug one another, that's exactly what happened.
Oh, wow.
The tears were flowing. I had a lump in my throat because it was such a great moment. She sent her out the room again. She came back in. It's Catherine. She sent her out the room again. She came back in. It's Catherine. But, I mean, there is literally lots of stories like that. And every trainer that's ever worked for OrCam,
including me,
they probably have bags of stories
of
how OrCam has impacted people's lives. Just the feeling of just integrating a piece of assistive technology like OrCam into somebody's daily living is very empowering. And that's why I love the tagline, our vision, empowering people.
I knew you were going to do that.
Yeah, it's my favourite tagline.
It's a good tagline, I like it. And it's a similar feature that we've got, so that's product recognition. So how does that work?
Product recognition works when we place our finger on the OrCam to take an image. The OrCam is then working out whether it's a human or whether it's a product.
Instant coffee 200G.
Sometimes the product is difficult to recognise, so the boffins at OrCam have kind of got that sussed. So essentially they also have a feature that reads barcodes too. If it's kind of an odd one, you know, because you do get odd ones every now and again, it allows you to actually put that barcode in too. We've got, my favourite is clock gesture mode.
The watch gesture.
So essentially it will just look at your wrist. You don't have to have a watch on, it's not reading your watch. It's reading the gesture of your wrist and it will tell you the time and the date, which I think is crazy.
The time is 3:01 p.m.
It's got Bluetooth, so you can connect it to anything. So you can connect it to any kind of wireless technology, be it AirPods or speakers, so you can listen to it. But a speaker that's actually on the device is fine too.
And if you're in a quiet environment and you want it turned down, you just simply slide your finger along from the front of the camera towards your ear and it'll tell you volume down. And if you swipe that each time, you can work it right down to it's a suitable level for you to hear it. I've got some customers who love pairing it off to their Echo Dot.
Okay.
So they're sitting in the armchair in the afternoon, cup of tea, book, reading the feature, and it's coming out the Echo Dot. You know, it's a great feature. I have to say, I use it myself from time to time.
The thing with OrCam is they listen to the customers, and one of the things that the old OrCam struggled with was low light conditions, you know, like in, you know, some bars and some dark restaurants. Well, this one basically will automatically kick in a light and flash, so the OrCam can read the text, and that works really well. Fantastic feature on this product. So the OrCam's also got an app that can sit on iOS. And again, that's really about listening to customers, because, well, not being funny, but it was a bit difficult getting into the settings on the previous version. But this one's so simple.
The app's a pretty cool thing. On the iOS platform just now, we are in development with the Android version. The iOS version, where we can go in, pair our OrCam off to our phone or our iPad, and we can change any setting from your phone and it will automatically change to the OrCam. And then we have a remote page where a little panel comes up in your phone and you can press the start button. It will take an image from your camera and read the text that's in front of you or identify the person that's in front of you. You can pause it, you can fast forward it, you can rewind it. And it all works off the phone. So if I'm sitting in the train, I can have my phone sitting on the table and I can tap and I can read whatever I need to read without having to make any gestures. So it's quite discreet because you're hearing it playing in your ear at the same time.
Well, that's an app version. Yeah. The voice commands are just as good, aren't they?
So you can use the vocal command to enter into certain parts of the menu. It's a shortcut. So when you double tap the touchpad, you'll get a pitch tone, and then you give it a voice command. For example, speak faster, speak slower, connect to Bluetooth audio device, or change voice.
Yep.
When you get to the change voice, it will give you the option to change English voice, the Spanish voice, or the French voice.
So that's a deep dive into the settings just by your voice.
Yeah, just by voice. Now, the good thing about this is people always say to me, but I'm Scottish. It doesn't understand Scottish people. It doesn't work on regional dialect. It works on the command alone, regardless whether you're a Mancunian, whether you're a Brummie, or whether you're a South Londoner.
Or Salfordian like me.
Yep, yep. It works simply on the voice command itself, the command that you give it.
There's a couple of nice little features that I like. So you can call your OrCam from your phone. So if you've got it in a bag somewhere or in a coat pocket and you can't find it, you can literally call it from the app on your phone. So it'll give the OrCam a tone. And also there's another feature where, say you leave your OrCam on your desk and you're off home, it'll actually send you a notification that you've left your OrCam on your desk, which I think is pretty cool. You don't even get that with your expensive Apple AirPod Pros.
You know, I've done it two or three times where I've walked away and left it, and it's indicated that I've left my OrCam sitting in the bench.
So the OrCam also does money recognition. So just stick a note in front of it, euros, dollars, sterling. It'll just tell you what it is, which is fantastic. The other thing on all of this is its speed and accuracy. From acquiring the text to reading out to you, we're talking milliseconds, which is what we want. We want things to be here and now, not waiting a while for it to come. And the OrCam is instantaneous. I think the other thing you've got to say is, you know, they've been out 4 years. This is still the only wearable OCR piece of technology in the world. And if there's anybody that's thinking about introducing something similar to this, don't bother, because this is top of the game.
And the good thing about OrCam is, guys, we listen to customer feedback. And one of the examples is when OrCam version 1 came out in the marketplace with the cable, yep, connected to the camera, everybody was saying it would be brilliant if it was wireless.
There you go.
We're wireless now.
Can I just mention one of the things that you wouldn't think I'd get excited about, but I do. What OrCam have done is create this charging lead, this magnetic connector, which is just bonkers. You know, it must have cost them a fortune, and not just in time, but in effort to create this charging lead that enables people with a visual impairment to easily charge the product by not being able to having to fiddle around with these connections. It just sticks on. It's just fantastic. I love it. That's just, you know, just one little feature of the OrCam. Everything else inside the device, to infinite detail, has been thought about for a reason. And you know, I've been around OrCam for 4 years. It kind of never stops, really. They're still trying to keep pushing themselves to make things better and better.
Talking about future plans, Mark, you know, we have got some exciting new plans already in the pipeline at the moment.
You always have.
They're coming up with some really cool features that I'm pretty excited to try out soon. No timeline on it.
Yeah.
Because, you know, we don't put a timeline on it for a reason.
Yeah.
But when it comes out, you know, our customers will be notified and they'll be pretty excited by them.
Well, I'll try and tap him for some insider tips, you know, buy him a couple of beers, you know what he's like here. Stay tuned. At the end of this video, I've got something really important to show you. So we said earlier that it's Wi-Fi connected, but it actually doesn't use Wi-Fi. Tell us a little bit, Ian.
Yeah, well, that's right. That's what makes OrCam so unique. It works completely offline. Everything you do is safe, it's data protected, it's encrypted. It doesn't rely on network connectivity. We don't rely on data bundles. We don't rely on cloud bases.
Yeah.
Everything you do is completely offline. So whether you're reading a letter from your bank manager, a personal letter from a lawyer, or you know, just a medical appointment, when OrCam reads that information to you, it doesn't retain that information as soon as it's finished. It's gone.
Yeah.
It's completely gone. Same with facial recognition. It can only recognize the faces of the people that you teach it to learn.
Yeah, inside the unit itself.
Inside the device. And that's what makes it so unique. We can use OrCam completely anywhere in the world. All we do is power it up, we clip it to our glasses, and we're good to go.
So, that is me and Ian talked, chatted, chewed the fat on the OrCam. So as always, if you want to help us to do more videos like this, subscribe, comment, give us a like, pass it on to your mates, do whatever you fancy. If you want to know anything about the OrCam, ask OrCam or ask me, because we'd know everything that you want to know. So until that day, I'll bid thee farewell.
So it's goodbye from me.
And it's goodbye from me. Goodbye. As promised, a sneaky peek of the very near future. The OrCam Read, which is essentially a handheld reader, and it's got freaking lasers.
Our videos are helping people across the world. If you found them useful, please donate on our website so we can keep making more videos like this in the future.
Henshaws. Supporting people with sight loss and a range of other disabilities to go beyond expectations.